Hey everybody, welcome to part 4 of painting a series. If you haven't watched my previous 3 parts, go to them and you'll get a bit of background where I'm at now. So I just wanted to show you what happens when you don't fix something that smears. So I started out using some Posca pen, which is acrylic marker, and I always, after I finish a pass, I always go over with gloss medium, which is like a clear glue liquid. And so this is a board that I started that didn't have, that was not fixed, meaning it's a smelly, I use Krylon. It's just a fixative, fine art fixative, and you have to put it on with a mask in a ventilated area, so, which I have done. So, if you can see, a lot of the areas are sort of smearing down from the black ink. And I just, that's when I put the gloss medium on. It activates it and then it makes it run. So sometimes that's what you want and that's great. But I decided that that's not what I want to do. But I just went with this one and I fixed the rest of the boards, the other 16 or 15. So I'm going to put this one down. And I'll show you a board that I just fixed. And of course, there's nothing about this being a painting yet because it's just in its infancy. But so you can see now that there's the marker is on here. Now, when I put the gloss medium on, I'll show you a close up after just for a second to show you that it's not running. And hopefully I'm right. Sometimes you can miss some areas with the fixative, and so that's okay too because it just gives you some variation. So what I use is, it's not in its container, but this is the container that I buy of gloss medium, which is from Novacolor Paints in California. And they are the awesomest paints because they're a third the price of paints that you buy in a retail store. So, and I go through lots of gloss medium, so that's why I buy it in large containers. And then I just put it in a small container, so it's easy to use. I can put it down for this purpose. I'll put it on while it's on the wall, so you can see. But I usually lay it on a flat surface. It just prevents drips and whatnot. If this drips, I've got a drop sheet here as well. So I'm just going to kind of put it down from the top. And you can put it on with a brush, and this is the brush I used for the last one. So, and this will demonstrate, like this will, if it's going to run, it's the brush, see, it just dripped on the other painting. It's the brush that pulls at it and makes it smear. The other way, and this is more common way that I do it, is I just use a rag or a blue Scott towel, like this one I have in my hand, and just basically looking in the light, because I want to make sure I got the whole thing covered, and you can tell where it's a little bit shiny, so you're going to get some reflection on the areas that are covered. And so I'm just going to sort of just gently with the rag, just to move it around. I find this way it drips less when you use a rag. Okay, now there's an area here that probably got missed because it's smearing, and there's some ink on here as well that I used, and I wasn't thinking that would run, but I guess it does too. So, you know, it's all a learning process. At this point, it doesn't really matter. It's not crucial because this is just the beginning of the painting, and it's really just a process, like I was saying, of you know, looking at what you like and keeping that or doing more of it, and looking at what you don't like and getting rid of it, either painting over it, using collage, whatever, just changing it. That's the beauty about acrylic is that it can be changed easily, unlike watercolors. So now that's pretty gross and sticky, so I'm gonna just check that out. So usually I just kind of wait a few minutes for this to dry. So I'll, and it's okay, you could start painting on it, it's no big deal. I'm gonna just start this one. And this, I got a big drip. I got some gloss medium on the top of the board, so I'll just wipe that off, because when this dries, it's hard, and it's really hard to get off once it's dried and hard. Okay, so I've got something to work with now, and I'm gonna try to work quickly just for the sake of this video. And also, it's good when I'm doing this because then I don't get to fuss too much. So I have my palette, which is basically cafeteria tray plastic from the dollar store. And I have some of these blue Scott towels, like this, you know, and they're wet, and they're like three layers. And then just a piece of parchment paper, and that keeps my paints wet longer. So I like that. So I'm not crazy about just using plain white, but right now I'm going to, just for time's sake. And then later on, I'll often come back and glaze over the certain areas. But yeah, it's rarely that I leave stark white on the painting till the end of the painting. So I'm not gonna think about this too much, but what I am just gonna do is just kind of look around the painting and just some areas that I do like. I really like, here I'm gonna show you a close up. And everybody's different, but I'm the one who's painting it, so. So let's see, where did it go? These areas here where I sprayed with water and this ink ran and sort of blossomed into the water, and then when it dried, it left these really cool looking, kind of natural looking, almost like something you'd see in nature, you know? Yeah. So I like when that happens, and this, whoops, sorry. Here, yeah, this is like super cool, loving it. See that? Things just mixing together naturally. Yeah, so I'm gonna, having said that, leave what you like. Sometimes you have to get rid of what you do like, because it can be to the detriment of the entire painting. So for now, it's not too important, because I've got several layers to go on this thing. So I'm just gonna start like right there. And I'm just putting the paint on pretty thick. And that's really my goal here, is just to put the paint on. I'm not thinking about making a painting right now. Although I am thinking about, you know, I want it, you know, I don't want all the white on one side, because that would look funny. There is a certain amount of thinking that's involved, even from the beginning. There's my favorite spot. I covered it now. Oh, well. Okay, let's just not get too picky here. Because the thing is, so the reason why I put the gloss medium on every time I do a pass on a painting is so if you decide, like, you don't want that covered, like, oh, I just covered that and I didn't really want it to, with the gloss medium on there, it gives a sort of a slippery texture to it. So if the paint's still wet and you decide you want to remove it somewhat, you can. So I've got a scraper here, and I'm just gonna pull that back away from the area that I didn't want to have the paint on. So, and this is an awesome tool. I use this a lot. It's a great way to move the paint around, but also change the thickness of the paint just by the angle, or how firmly you press it. So it's great for texture. And it kind of takes your hand out of it a little bit. So I know you're thinking, why is she covering everything now? So the thing is, in this process of just like putting stuff down, you're creating a history that's going to show through the paint that you put on afterwards. So that's kind of the goal here, is to get something down so that you have something to respond to, and then go from there. So I could get really, if I'm by myself, I get kind of finicky and take my time. But so I'm just standing back from this a little bit, and right now I just kind of want it to be balanced a bit. Okay, we've got a lot of this white here, and when I have white over top of a color, it just invites me to scrape through it. So that's, you know, that may not stay, but I just like scrapes. Again, it's just about finding out, you know, mistakes are meant as tools to figure out what you like. And so the more mistakes you make, the more you learn. It's just pretty kind of basic, but I know it sounds basic. But... okay, so I'm gonna just move a little bit like there, and I don't want the same size area, so I'm trying to vary it a little bit. So I'm putting this paint on down here, like super thick. And then I'm going to show you another tool. And it, you know, some things happen, actually most things happen that you like by accident. It's the way the paint, like there, it just kind of grabs on in some spots. Like I'm not painting that shape. It's just doing that because of the conditions of the, you know, the brush and how much paint is on it and, you know, on and on. So I'm getting some, like, definitely got some contrast going on here. You know, and this is just a development of this painting. Another tool that I absolutely love that you can only get, well, I ordered mine on through Art to Life, but they don't deliver to Canada, unfortunately. So I did have an opportunity to have it delivered to someone who lived in California. So I got it and I'm so happy. It's got rounded corners, which is nice. And it's a little bit pliable, but it's super great to take your hand out of the artwork. So here I could just like smooth that down. Or if I chose to, I can like again, with the other tool, I can scrape it. And so I can scrape it to actually like cover more, or, you know, it's just, it depends on how you want it. Like here, I'm just pulling it down and it's leaving like a little bit of snow to cover that. Just changing a little bit. I like how it gives smoothness to the piece, especially in the beginning, because there's going to be so many layers. It's good to have, wipe that off, because when this is covered with paint, it's harder to clean. So that's, you know, that's where we are. Sometimes you just have to act impulsively just to see what happens. And that's probably all I want to do for that, because if I keep going, it's just too much. It's too much concentration. It's too focused for this process, the way I paint. You know, as the painting moves on, then it becomes, you know, the process becomes slower because you're putting more detail into it. You're really narrowing down like what you like, and you're getting it, you know, the painting's coming to its own life. I really like this color here. I love how the drips of water ran through the black, and then I lifted it, and it left these nice little... So I like quite a bit on this. Here, it doesn't really matter. I can just easily cover that. No big deal. Just kind of start putting little patches where... See, some, I don't like too much of this line work, so we're just going to cover up some of that. And this is a great brush because it's large enough for this size of painting that... you can cover quite a bit in a short period of time. But again, I'm using the same brush, which is not imperative at this point. It's more when you get to closer to the end, you want to also vary your tools, because that's a contrast as well. It's just some reason I'm going with, I don't usually have square edges, but right now I'm just deciding to do that. Let's see if we can move that, smooth that up. use the edge of it and give me a nice straight line there. I mean, this is not necessary right now, but it's kind of like the early part of your painting is an opportunity to practice a whole bunch of things, because it's not really dear in the beginning. Kind of liking, I don't want to add too much more white at this moment. I'm going to paint over that brown and then I'm going to bring it into the black. And then I'm going to scrape it back so that you can see it, but not very much. So you can tell that there was something there before. And I think this is mostly white, but I know there's some black lines over here. And you can pull it back and then stop, or however, you know, you want to leave it. It's just playing. It's just really, this is a process of exploration in this stage, which I love because that's where most of the learning comes from. I'm just going to take this up. Oh, that didn't do what I thought it would. Okay, I just want to get this paint off here. Easier to just take it off on the painting than waste it on your paper towel. I'm just trying playing around with different textures. This is soft, this is hard edged, and kind of, you know, just giving it a little bit of variety. So you can imagine that working on 16 panels is fairly time consuming. It's going to take me a while to get them all done, but there's a huge advantage to working in a series, what I've discovered, and that is that it keeps your work consistent. You can use the same palette if you want. You can use a couple palettes at the same time. It works well for me anyway. And at the beginning, it keeps me in that, you know, not too focused on one thing. You know, I don't think I could actually paint a painting from the beginning to the end, just one painting now. This is way more fun. It keeps it fresh, keeps it informed. It helps you, you know, learn something from one to the next. So, okay, so that's something. Just at the beginning, and as I go along, most of my response is based on contrast, either value contrast or texture versus smooth or line versus solid, or any kind of difference that you can bring into the piece is going to bring it more alive and make it more interesting for the person who's looking at it. So I didn't realize all these things about abstract art, but now I find it quite intriguing. So that's all I'm going to do because, you know, this just takes too long. I need to figure out how to make the video go by faster. Anyway, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. I got white paint on my finger and I'm going to put it on my phone.